2,500 kilometers through Mongolia. From the capital Ulaanbaatar, I decided for the southern route to the west. Because other tourists told me that the more northern way was blocked by flooding. After the border crossing in the late afternoon, I headed for Ulaanbaatar, 350 kilometers. But because of the villages and moderate roads, I arrived there only at midnight. In Ulaanbaatar, I had the luck of a completely individual city guidance by Tatsral, which I met at the Russian-Mongolian border. In addition to the Goethe-Institut, there was even a Frankfurt pub in Ulaanbaatar. Then I started finally into western direction, initially on newly built roads. Even nomads don't want to give up modern technology anymore. With animals and bicycles, one moves to the summer pasture. Every province and every city has magnificent city gates. In the cities, however, you have to pay tolls, mostly 1,000 tökrök. This is about a 30 euro cent. Only when you get closer, it becomes clear what it is. In the middle of the desert, a monument for the best horses. Parking lots were also thought of along the highway, and they are not as crowded as in Europe. In accommodation on the road. Simple but clean. Only there is usually no water pipe. And no sewage pipes as well. Through the Gobi Desert, at first still sandy desert. Up to here the road is finished. But then the signage is not always clear. And promptly I got 100 km off the road at such a place. The red marked road I wanted to drive on the blue marked way right across the Terra I drove then finally. But see for yourself. First, a coffee break and thinking. You can take the compass or you orient yourself at the telegraph poles. Usually they lead into a village, but sometimes not. Then they just stop. Or you ask the locals. Or you follow a bus that goes back to the main road sometimes. Another coffee break, finally. Now I knew why the highway was closed here. Because actually it is finished, but the bridge had probably not survived the high water of the last winter. As I was told, this is a sign to a village, not to a rest house. In any case, there is no fuel shortage in Mongolia. On each side of a village, you find at least 3 or 4 gas stations. Once again, a dinner in a hotel. However, I was the only guest. Most of the time I drove through the Stone Desert Gobi. The Sand Desert Gobi is more southeastern, rather in direction of China. New roads need new traffic signs. Another 1000 Tukrek for the road toll. In the border area to Russia, the Mongolian side of the Altai Mountains came in sight slowly. Ölgi or Ulgi, the last bigger city before the Russian border. In a reading cafe, there was delicious cappuccino. Unfortunately, I couldn't read anything. Oh yes, and at the dentist, I had to get a filling for 3 euro, which is $5. Funny that you had to put on slippers. Then the Mongolian checkpoint. By the way, the departure from Mongolia was the fastest border crossing on the whole trip. Only two questions. Do you have anything illegal in the car? No. Are you sure? Yes. Okay, good travel. Then I drove about for 40 kilometers through no man's land to the Russian entry control point.